tell them, guys, welcome back to the channel. Today, interesting video. I'm gonna start this, I'll make a playlist, why is Swamiji an avatar? And how is Swamiji recognized as an avatar as per Hinduism? An incarnation of Paramashiva as per Hinduism. So without further ado, I welcome you all with my love and respects and the blessings of my Guru, His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. Today in the video, I wanted to, there's a book actually called Avatar Shastra. I'll put the link in the description below. And that is the first volume of the science of an avatar, how avatar lands and how to recognize them and all that. So today I wanted to share one part of it at the beginning, which are some of the attributes that the avatar needs to embody. So there are many attributes and they should all be happening and manifesting through a being for that being to be recognized as an avatar of Paramashiva. So I'm going to jump into that right now. So here we have 12 attributes. The first one is Kalpataru, the wish fulfillment. So an avatar, when you truly desire something in your inner space and you enter into the presence of the avatar, and if you have an opportunity, even if you hold it inside, it will happen. But if even more, if you have an opportunity to share it with him, he will manifest it. An avatar will be able to manifest the reality you want for yourself. But it has to be sincere. It means you really need to grasp inside your inner space what you want, not some superficial desires which are just at the surface of the mind, but really the desires you have at the depth of your being. So these desires will be manifested around an avatar, in the presence of an avatar. And Swamiji naturally manifests and radiates this this power of Kalpataru, this quality attribute of Kalpataru. Many, many devotees experience different forms of miracles, different forms of things aligning and happening in their life because of just getting one blessing, one boon from Swamiji. So that is, I think that's the most important one, because Shiva is fulfilling the wishes of his devotee, right? He's the boon giver. So Kalpataru is the main quality of Shiva, of Paramashiva. He sits and he just blesses and makes things happen, right? So that quality is very important and it is very much present in Swamiji. Next we have perpetual completion, aka enlightenment. Obviously, enlightenment is required. That is the foundation of the recognition of an avatar. Complete completion means you really realize that you are the super consciousness and you experience, you see that super consciousness in everything. You can see how Swamiji engages with people. He will always engage at a very one-on-one intimate level with the being. And he will always raise the being and attend to the being's powerlessness so that the being realizes that he is Paramashiva. So this capacity to enter into deep intimacy instantly, in a moment, he can just enter into that space with someone. And even sometimes, many times people share that, you know, we're all in a group, but everybody feels he's attending to us one-on-one. So that is one of the attributes and manifestation that happens through a being considered as an avatar as per Hinduism. And Swamiji is also very much radiating this one. Next one is healing. Obviously, it's a capacity to infuse consciousness, Kundalini Shakti, and heal people inside in the body, any forms of healing, psychological or physical. Swamiji was sharing once that he says, everything I do in healing is I just enter into in my body and I just enter into that life positiveness. See, he says not enter into life positiveness. He says my body radiates life positiveness. So the moment your body comes next to me, the biomemory my biomemory jumps onto you and heals you. Because the only reason why we have ailments is because we have life negative cognitions. But when we enter into the presence and receive healing or blessing from an avatar, then his life positiveness that is sitting inside his biomemory automatically gets in contact with our biomemory, and our biomemory remembers that this is the pure state that we're supposed to be in, and automatically healing happens. So healing is one of them. Next one is Diksha Akarshana, transfer of bioenergy. So yeah, that actually, that should refer to basically Kundalini Shakti, how Swamiji with an initiation, he can simply awaken the Kundalini Shakti and give us the experience of super consciousness. Most of the time people do tapas, penances for years and years before they can have a glimpse of it. But Swamiji, just like that, he can give a glimpse of that super conscious energy and experience to anybody. And that is why he is considered an avatar. That is very rare. Enlightened beings, there's a difference between avatar and enlightened beings. Enlightened beings might be enlightened, but they might not radiate all the attributes. So to be an avatar, you have to radiate everything. So that is one very important one. So then Swamiji says, my challenge is not giving you the experience. My challenge is giving you the powerful cognition so that you can raise yourself and hold on to that experience. So next one, Akashic reading, capacity to access the Akashic records, past, present, future. Swamiji has done countless Akashic readings where he invokes Kalabhairava and Kalabhairava reveals what needs to be revealed. And he also initiated others into Akashic reading that will come later on. But the transmission, the capacity to transmit the power of Akashic reading also. So yes, that is great. If you want to check on YouTube, Nityananda Akashic Reading, and you will have various videos where Swamiji invokes Kalabhairava and Kalabhairava reveals the Akashic readings as they are. Next is Vijnana Akarshana, true knowledge. So yes, in the satsangs, when Swamiji, especially recently, you know, he's sharing about the five phases of Paramashiva and the five faces of Paramashiva and how creation, sustenance, rejuvenation, dissolution, pulling out of delusion and liberation are the five phases of Paramashiva. And each of these phases have five faces, which is also creation, sustenance, rejuvenation, pull out of delusion and liberation. So it creates the 25 heads of Paramashiva. So all this is just raw, pure knowledge from the Shastras, from Paramashiva, and contemplating on that allows that experience to happen in you, and it allows the brain to develop the subtle grooves, which allows you to grasp these truths. Next, we have Shiva Akarshana, the space of Shiva. So yes, like I said, being in the space of Shiva, where people experience, they can, many of us have experienced Swamiji as Shiva, literally. We would have seen him as Shiva, or we would have been brought to a space where we saw him as Shiva. And so yes, radiating that attribute. Then we have Shakti Akarshana, the Kundalini energy. So obviously being able to awaken the Kundalini and play with the Kundalini. When Swamiji does mandala processes, he literally plays with Devi, the Kundalini energy within us, so that we can raise our frequencies and experience the higher states of consciousness. Then we have Ardhanarishwara, beyond duality, feminine and masculine embodied in a single form. And that is very much present in Swamiji, how sometimes he will radiate that very strong and powerful masculine dimension of consciousness, and some other time he will be radiating that feminine dimension of consciousness. Sometimes he looks literally like a female body, and sometimes he looks like a totally male body. So like that, whether it is physical or just by the way he is, in both ways, he radiates both spectrums of super consciousness, masculine and feminine. Ardhanarishwara. Then we have Shushada, beyond pain. So yes, Swamiji had many experiences where, you know, he broke his arm and he was laughing and joking around, and literally the pain experience is not experienced by an avatar, because he is beyond the space of duality, beyond the body, beyond everything. So he no longer cognizes the lower frequency of existences such as pain. Then we have Divya Sharira, that is very much actual right now. Swamiji is conducting programs. When he does, it is only through Divya Sharira. So in a hologram, he projects his light body into the place where the program is happening, or everywhere around the world. And literally, he becomes present, and people have a lot of experiences where they feel him, they see him, they can see, for instance, chairs rotating on their own when he is sitting in the middle of the mandala process. in his Divya Sharira, not in his physical form, in his Divya Sharira. So that is very much there. And the last one we have here is Surabhi, the fragrant physiology. So many of us have experienced where you come near to Swamiji, there is a kind of holy fragrance, divine, sacred fragrance, which is just there. And even sometimes when you connect with him, you can just smell it, you can just experience it. So that is one of the attributes. So that's what I wanted to share with you guys today. This is the first video of the playlist of the series. So why is Swamiji an avatar? And naturally, once you realize that he's an avatar, then why you should have him part of your life. So if you guys like, comment, subscribe to the channel, share these videos with people. People need to know that this is a possibility available to us right now. An avatar is made available to us. And he's made available and he wants to enrich and contribute and raise us. So we should not become an obstacle to that, so that we can experience the pure auspiciousness and bliss and change our lives really in the way we want. So with this, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Nityananda.
I welcome you all with my love and respect. Let you all open all your three eyes. Om Nityananda.